We begin
our evening service in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Oh, Lord, bless our lives.
And answer to form thy name. Oh, God, this day to save us. Son, to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise ye the Lord.
Who dies at 100
thought a mere child. The one who fails to reach 100 will be considered accursed. They will build houses and will dwell in them. They will plant vineyards and eat their own fruit. No longer will they build houses and other lives in them, or plant and other seed. For as the days of a tree, so will be the days of my people. My chosen ones will long enjoy the works of their hands. They will not labor in vain, nor will they bear children doomed in misfortune. For they will be a people blessed by the Lord, and they their descendants with them. Before they call, I will answer. While they are still speaking, I will hear. The wolf and the lamb will feed together, and the lion will eat straw like the ox, and dust will be like the servant's food. They will neither harm nor destroy on all my holy mountains. This is the word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Office hymn, Ancient and Modern, 24:2-4.
Son of my soul, thou Savior dear, thank you.
Magnificat.
Hear the word of God as it is written in St. Luke chapter 2, verses 1 to 20. St. Luke Gospel chapter 2, 1 to 20. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem to the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. And when were the shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night, an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. And the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find the baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angel had left and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in a manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about the child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. This is the word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Nunc dimittis. Nunc dimittis.
Thank you. God, you are doing us your only begotten Son to take our nature upon him, and that is to be born of a pure virgin. Grant that we who have been born again and made your children by adoption and grace may be renewed daily by your Holy Spirit. Just in thy Son Jesus Christ, our Lord, who's alive and raised with you. It's only to one God now and forever.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, from whom all desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servant that peace the world cannot give, that both our hearts may set away thy commandments, and so that the body will be from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
Light in our darkness will be saved today, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils in the days of this night. For the love of the Son, Savior, Jesus Christ, who's alive and rest with you now and forever.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us bless the Lord.
Shall say the words of the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Hymn Ancient and Modern 329 in 329.
To the Lord, God.
seated and let us pray. Gracious God, we thank you for the gift of Christ to humanity. That through the birth of Christ and his acceptance to come to the world, we have been reconciled to you. We pray you that, Lord, as we commemorate this nativity, may we be mindful of the fact that you have called us in relationship, and therefore we have to live so that you favor us all the days of our lives. We have had this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Viewers, turn to me to the Gospel of Luke, the first chapter, verse 30 to 25. Luke chapter 1, verse 30 to 35. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb a bare son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will have no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel answered and said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. And for that reason, the Holy Child shall be called the Son of God." This is the word of God. Before I proceed, let me wish you a Merry Christmas. The year has been so challenging, so difficult, but God's goodness and mercy has brought us that far. So we say to God, thank you for taking us through this challenge and bringing us where we are this day. As we celebrate Christmas, it reminds us that God still loves us, and that he has called us in relationship to himself through the birth of Christ. And therefore, this evening, I want to speak on the theme, position yourself so that God will favor you. Position yourself so that God will favor you. When we listen to the reading for this evening, in our liturgy, we call the Annunciation, the birth of Christ to Mary. The angel came to Mary with a message, and the angel told her that you have been chosen by God, you have found favor with God, and therefore you are going to bear the Son of God. You are going to give birth to a son, who shall be called Jesus. Mary asked, she didn't doubt, but I said, "How can this be, since I am a single person? I don't have anybody to give me the child in my womb. I have no husband." The angel answered her that the Holy Spirit will take care of that. Then she said, "Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be unto me according to your word." My theme is, position yourself to find favor with God. What make Mary to find favor with God? What is this about her that God, among all the women, the young women in Israel at that time, God decided that this is the woman that will bear the Holy Son? There's something that's so special, that was unique about Mary, for which God picked her out of the many young women at that time. Scholars have come out with reasons why God decided to use Mary as the bearer of the Son of God. The first and foremost thing that God found Mary a woman of purity. God found in her a woman of purity. Even though she had been betrothed to Joseph, they had never had any affair. Even though she was in the house of Joseph, there had not been any affair. Which means that Mary has respected her virginity, has respected who she is, and she's waiting for the time that they finish the marriage process. This is the first stage before they have an affair. Joseph wasn't a man like some of us, some of our girlfriends. Before the next stage, we have to go in before we say that this is my girlfriend, now I'll marry you. Joseph was also a man of chastity. She respected Mary. And therefore, God realized that this is the woman who can bear, because she has high moral standard, which is lacking in our community and the world today. So that's the first point scholars have come up with. That because of her chastity, she can be the woman who can train, who can nurture this holy son. The second element that was found in her is that she is a woman of humility. When the angel spoke to her, she didn't just come out and say, "Hey, me, hey, I'm there." I said, "How can this be? How can this be?" She knows she has a husband, she has a man by her side. She can say, "Oh, praise the Lord, thank you very much. Then let me go in. Let me give all out." But because of that humility, he asked, "How can this be?" And then just say, "The Holy Spirit take care of what I just do." Proverbs says that humility brings wealth, life, and honor. It brings wealth, life, and honor. Today, all over the world, Mary is seen as a Theotokos, the mother of God. And therefore, she is worshipped. Many things have been named after her. She has got the honor. She has the wealth before the eyes of God. And her name is still being what? Mentioned. Because she's still alive. She's not dead. Hallelujah. The third element that scholars attempt to attribute the reason why God chose Mary is that she confessed her faith. He said, "Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to your word." It means that she believed in God's word. She believed that what God says is true and will come to pass. So she has faith in the word of God. She didn't doubt like Zachariah. But she accepted the word of God and said, "Because you have said it, let it happen to me according to what you have said." That's a challenge to most of us Christians today. We hear the word of God, but to accept it and to apply it is another thing altogether. But Mary, when she heard the word of God, she humbly and gladly says, "I receive it. I receive it." As sometimes when they pour some cologne machine blessing on us, then say, "I receive it." Because it's about your prosperity. But when you read the word of God, then you close your eyes and bow down your head. But Mary knows what it is, so she receives it. And the last thing is that when you look at St. Luke's Gospel, the same chapter 2 that was read, you look at the last verse. It says, and Mary kept all these things in her heart. And Mary kept all these things in her heart. So it means that she is not like other women, excuse me, women. She is not like other women who go about gossiping, who go about telling stories, exaggerating about what they are not even seen or heard. But Mary, though she saw it, Garfini Gardochi, she never went to tell anybody until it came to pass. When she was told that your cousin Elizabeth is also in the same category with you, she went there. It was Mary who said, when you beat me, the baby lived in their womb, and you have also been blessed. It was Mary, Elizabeth, who saw what is there. So then it is true. So Mary kept her mouth shut. God knows that she's a woman who will not go about bragging that I am the bearer of the Holy One. I am the bearer of the Son of Man. I am the bearer of the Son of God. I'm the bearer of this and that and that. No. And even when Jesus was born, she never go about, this is my son, this is my son, this is my son. She was following like other women in the group. So for this reason, scholars have come out to say that God decided to choose her among many women. She found favor because she positioned herself by being humble, by keeping her mouth, by believing the word of God, and by accepting the challenge. So this evening, as we celebrate Christmas, it's almost ended today. But tomorrow is another day, but we are in the festive mood. Let us position ourselves to receive the blessing of God. As I said, there were so many women in Israel at that time, but she was found favor in the sight of God. And God chose her to bear the Son of God or the Son of Man. Let us position ourselves as we walk through this world, as we go through the 2023. Let's put ourselves in the position that God will see us. Let us be humble. Let us take the word of God as it is. Let us trust God. Let us always and always be able to bridle our tongue to say only the word of God, but not to brag and to say things that are not supposed to be said, but all that we say and do will glorify God, and God will take us and favor us in the year 2023. May the living God be with us. And as we close the year, may He favor us with His blessing and for that we need, so that at the end of our life journey, we shall find a place where He is. In the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Recessional hymn, Ancient and Modern, 21:2:1.
Thank you.
Ancient and Modern, 311. 311 Part 2. 311 Part 2.
Let us thank God at this time for his goodness and for his mercies. For his loving kindness towards us in the past months and having brought us to the last but one week of the year. Let us thank him for this goodness and mercy. Let us thank him for our nation, Ghana. It has been very turbulent. Very stormy for us this year. But God has not left us alone. He has been with us, protected, defended, guided, directed. And we are where we are today. They give me the praise, honor, and adoration. Let us thank God for the favor he has done as a nation. He knows us. He knows our needs. And the Lord has been so good to us as a nation. Let us thank him. Let us thank him for our individual lives. For his loving kindness towards us. He has not left us on our own. But he has cared for us. As we come to the close of the year, let us ask God to continue to remember us. God should remember us as we sing the hymn 283. Oh, thou from whom all goodness flows. Soul of Christ, sanctify me.
Soul of Christ, sanctify me.
Body of Christ, wash me.
Body of Christ, wash me.
Blood of Christ, defend me.
Blood of Christ, defend me.
Water from the side of Christ, wash me.
Water from the side of Christ, wash me.
Passion of Christ, strengthen me.
Passion of Christ, strengthen me.
O good Jesus, hear me.
O good Jesus, hear me.
Within thy wounds, hide me.
Within thy wounds, hide me.
Suffer me not to be separated from thee.
Suffer me not to be separated from thee.
From the malicious enemy, defend me.
From the malicious enemy, defend me.
In the hour of my death, call me.
In the hour of my death, call me.
And bid me come to thee.
And bid me come to thee.
That thy saints I may praise thee.
That thy saints I may praise thee.
Forever and ever.
Forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Ancient and Modern 309, 309, Part 2.
Give us them bread from heaven. So to venerate the sacred mystery of thy body and blood, that we may approve and receive with ourselves the fruit of thy redemption, through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be in his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be Jesus in the most sacred holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be the Holy Ghost, the Comforter.
Blessed be the Holy Ghost, the Comforter.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy.
Blessed be a holy immaculate conception.
Blessed be the holy and immaculate conception.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse.
Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse.
Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.
Blessed be God in his angels and his saints.